pathway like the back of my hand. I felt the earth beneath my feet. Sat by the river and it made me complete. Oh, simple thing, where have you gone? I'm getting old and I need something to rely on. So tell me, gonna let me in. I'm getting tired and I need somewhere to begin. I came across a fallen tree. I felt the branches of it looking at me. Is this the place we used to love?
I'm Robert, and we have the Owyhee Volcanics.
And join us on our nature walk!
Before we get started on our nature hike, here is some background information on the Owyhee Volcanics.
The rocks that are found and involved in the formation of the Owyhee Volcanoes are rhyolite, which has the same composition as granite. Both of these are rich in silica and alkali elements. The rocks that are found are extremely old. Some reach over 8 million years.
On the first stop of our nature tour, we are in the southwest part of Idaho, and we are in the part where the Owyhee Volcanics intersect with the western part of the Snake River. Take a look. The Owyhee Volcanics formed during the Miocene Epoch time period. After the mountain range was formed, the Snake River cross-cut the mountains, leaning the Snake River Basin. These were also formed by volcanic eruptions and by the rapid cooling of the magma.
Hey Robert!
What's up?
Do you want to know a fun fact about the Owyhee Volcanoes?
What?
That they're made up of two different fault directions, so it makes it really difficult to locate.
I didn't even know that.
Well, now you
what?
Know.
Another fun fact is the western part of the Owyhee Volcanics, where it intersects with the Snake River Plain, is a classic rift graben, in some ways similar to the rift basins of East Africa. Here we are on our second stop of our nature tour. We are in the central southern part of Idaho near Boise.
The offsets in the basalt and rhyolite units are easy to document because in many places they are right next to sedimentary lithologies.
Bimodal volcanism dominates in both the eastern and western plains. Volcanism began with rhyolitic ash and lava flows and accumulated with the eruption of basalt volcanoes.
And here we are at our final location on our nature tour in the southeast part of Idaho.
This area was active in the late 1800s. In the 1970s, mining began again with the development of the open pit silver gold mines.
Caught a trucker out of Philly, had a nice long toke. But he's headed west from the Cumberland Gap to Johnson City, Tennessee. I gotta move on before the sun. I hear my baby calling my name, and I know that she's the only one. And if I die in Raleigh, at least I will die free. So write me mama.
According to Oregon's Owyhee Canyonlands, the spectacular geological formations and incised river canyons in the Owyhee Canyonlands set it apart from any other place in the world. Here, the complex interaction of volcanism, faulting, and sediment deposition have fashioned a landscape of distinct beauty and created distinct microhabitats suited for specific flora and fauna.
Thank you for joining us on our nature tour, and we hope you learned as much as we did about the Owyhee Volcanics. See ya!
Bye!
Rock me, rock me.